If you like, you can just copy them now over to that system which they can see in India and send some over.
Unedited film has so much, many hours of looking at the sky or trees or this.
So you should make
edited version.
Edited and then make, and then we can take and we can show there.
Perhaps we can arrange to get
how it can be arranged.
Perhaps we can arrange to get VCR. We can just do copy portions from these to a VCR on PAL. But we need a machine and tapes.
Renting, that can be done here.
Renting, or just either way.
Yeah, we can.
We can do it. We'll make the arrangements.
Well, I will return from Australia, being Singapore. Can we help?
Maybe, probably you can make anything for us while we are gone on the Australian tour. We can have a, we'll try to do our best.
We need a video camera to
yes, video.
I'm sure that the Indians would be satisfied.
If we get a VCR, then during the tour, we can take it with us on travel. We can make copies during the day through the VCR onto VHS.
Especially in Australia, you might have better potential there.
Nastasya, your wife will join us?
No, she is in the United States.
Huh?
She's in America.
She's in America.
Oh.
She offers her heartfelt blessings.
Yes, very heartfelt blessings to us. Where is Gopinath and others?
They have been going to do some errands at Gokul's house. I don't think Gokul is also here.
No, they are still in Gokul's house.
Gokul is not here.
They will be coming any moment.
How are you? You are? Huh? When you reached here?
3 weeks.
Hmm?
3 weeks.
3 weeks. Before where you were?
Bhubaneswar.
For some time.
Then one kirtan you should do. Mridanga, kapa, or he should do. You should do one kirtan and he will do Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Serial orders. I want that I was willing to come to Malaysia, Singapore and all other cities and countries. We felt that to have a visa for Malaysia, that is not so easy. We have fixed our date for 22nd of January, but till 28th January, we are not seeing any sign of having the visa. So all were worried for this. But I was thinking that if Krishna does not want, if Swamiji does not want to be in Malaysia or Singapore, no harm. I should follow the happiness of Krishna. So I must follow him. But I was thinking that anyhow, if it is received, it will be so good. At last, on 28th in the night, I heard that this advocate or
barrister
has gone to embassy and he has argued there, and they are now ready to be visa and to order. All became so happy. So we all prayed to Krishna for her happiness and to be merciful to what name?
Surely.
Surely. So now I want to hear something. When I am here, how she feels and how I can do here. So I want that you should say something before my classes.
Because the thing is asking for the guidance when you are saying your
problems. No, this.
Like, they are preparing.
Achha. Wait a little. I'm hardly hearing.
She says that because we need guidance and being in your presence, and then she was trying to continue.
Achha, to you should.
Please speak up.
Go.
When we are in your presence, I feel that there's peace and sovereignty in my life. And the more I see you, maybe I can learn more and learn something. And maybe by Krishna's mercy, I will someday become somebody.
You understand?
I understand, but you should clear.
In your presence, we feel so much peace and tranquility. Yeah, that we are so happy to be in your presence, and hopefully by the mercy of Krishna, one day she hopes to become a good person.
I think that she is a good person. But she should learn how to place the God or Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna. No? And I know that you will be very chaste devotee. You should stand up. Chalo. Because we have come to your place. This is your place. You can come anywhere. Here or here and
Francisco.
He should come and stand up and speak something. Let them him stand here and you should be there.
श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्रीअद्वैत गदाधर शिवाचार्य भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम राम राम
from different exalted Rasik Vaishnavas like our beloved Srila Prabhupada, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, and Shri Sridhar Maharaj, our own Gurudev, Shri Gokulinda Maharaj, and those who are following our beloved Siksha Gurudev, Bhaktivedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj. And by the mercy of Krishna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, somehow the devotees who came here for the purpose of raising funds for India, we met up with devotees like Prankishore Prabhu and Urukran Prabhu, who have been very faithful disciples of Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada Maharaj. And they have been blessed with the wonderful association of both Srila Sridhar Maharaj and also our beloved Srila Narayana Maharaj. And by coming in contact with them, we have learned so much more about Krishna Bhakti and the special wealth of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that was stored in the heart of Sri Rupa Goswami Prabhupada, and that was brought to us by the exalted preachers produced by Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And so we have, after the disappearance of our beloved Gurudev, most mercifully been introduced to the wonderful association of Srila Narayana Maharaj. And I feel I'm learning so much. The devotees in Malaysia have all been so much inspired by the wonderful presence of the Gita
Pasana. Now seems but he also followed and get it to Shamrani, his description.
So by the mercy of our Prabhupada Swami Maharaj, we have heard about 80 tapes of his beautiful bhajans by Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Narottam Das Thakur, Lochan Das Thakur, describing the glories of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and the Vaishnavas and Sri Gurudev, and also glorifying Sri Gurudev and praying to him for his mercy so that we could develop Krishna consciousness. Then when we met Srila Narayana Maharaj, we could understand his qualities by having heard the bhajans that Prabhupada gave us, and also by Srila Narayana Maharaj's inspiration, we went further into the books of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Sharanagati, Gitavali, Gitamala, and Prarthana, Prem Bhakti Chandrika of Srila Narottam Das Thakur. And just as Prabhupada taught us, there's Guru, Sadhu, and Shastra who verify, confirm, and establish each other. So the Guru gives us the prarthanas, the prayers, the bhajans, and the bhajans also give us the Guru, tell us the qualities of the Guru, the powers of the Guru, how to pray to the Guru, and how to feel humble before the Guru. So Krishnadas Prabhu very kindly sang Gurudev earlier. This was Gaudavana Maji, you sang? Godruma Diachostani? Yes. So in this particular song, as in other songs, the glories of Srila Narayana Maharaj, Srila Gurudev, are established, that we have no power to chant the holy name of Krishna even without the mercy of Sri Gurudev. Kabi Kintu Prabhu Yogyate Arpibe, that you, O Gurudev, gave me the order that stay in Godruma, in the Goda forest, and chant the holy name of Krishna. But, O Prabhu, O Gurudev, when will you give me the qualification to be able to chant the holy name in such a way that my consciousness is steady, that I can engage in Ekanta Bhajanera Hari, that I can engage in Bhaji Bohari, that I can engage in bhajan with undivided attention. Because of my past activities in my childhood and youth, the song says, Saisa Bhajobane, Jada Sangha Sukhe, Jada Sukha Sange. I've become intoxicated by the pleasures of Jada. Jada means dead matter. And I've become addicted to bad habits. And so, because of Nija Karma Dosha, because of my own, Nija means my own, faults of my own karma, my body, this very body, has become an impediment to devotional service, bhajanera pratibandha. So all these siddhantas, all the philosophical truths are there in the bhajans. And how to feel in relation to Gurudev is there in the bhajans. So tomara charana, therefore I pray to your lotus feet. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is teaching us how to pray to Gurudev. Weeping, I'm praying to your lotus feet. And Parichaya Shubhiwala, taking full shelter at your lotus feet, that without your mercy I have no power to chant the holy name of Krishna. So many other bhajans, like by the association of the Ganges, after a long period of time, we become free from sins. But simply, O Gurudev, by a moment of your association, all sins go far away, simply by your glancing. Sri Gurudev has so much power that he takes away millions and millions of births of past sins and makes unqualified persons like myself. He can give us the great wealth of Krishna Prema. He was explaining, Gurudev Narayan Maharaj was explaining, that even on the material platform, Sri Gurudev has so much power to help the disciple. He told one story about one lady disciple in Mathura, and she was bringing him some gifts, some fruits or something. And he said, why are you bringing this to me? She said, well, the other day I was drowning in the river, and I called out, hey Gurudev, save me, save me. And I felt your long arm coming and grabbing me and bringing me onto the shore. So therefore, today I brought you these fruits because you've saved me. So Gurudev said, actually, I have no qualification, but actually she was right. So Gurudev on every level has so much power. And then he told one story about a disciple whose guru ordered him to clog up a dam because there was water coming and destroying the agriculture. So it was very, very bad weather at night, and he couldn't find any way to hold up the dam. So he himself laid his whole body in front of the dam. And the guru came the next day and saw him trembling and shivering from the cold. And when he saw the sacrifice and service he did, he made all the Vedas manifest in his heart and tongue. So everything is possible only by the mercy of Sri Gurudev. So we're just so fortunate that we have such a powerful personality that even if he doesn't speak anything, like he said, when you go to a holy place like Javat or Nandagaon, and even if that holy place doesn't speak to you, still just by sitting there, the atoms of that place give Krishna prema. Similarly, if one goes to the feet of such a holy person, even if he doesn't say anything, or even if he speaks in another language, like for us, Hindi is another language, I mean, we may not understand it so well. But he said, even if you don't understand it, the atoms, or even if he says nothing, the atoms of his Krishna prema go from his heart into our heart and give Krishna prema. Or even just by his glancing, that glance carries all the pastimes of Radha and Krishna and all of his realizations, and they enter into the serious disciple. So we're very, very fortunate to have his kind association, and we're very fortunate that he's given us such nice bhajaniyas like Krishna Das Prabhu to teach us so many nice bhajans. And we have so many books of bhajans. So many books of bhajans. to understand more our relationship with Sri Gurudev. Just like I asked him a question about a half hour ago, can you explain something to me? And he said, I'll tell you later after you finish the painting. So he didn't give me any answer, but just by his saying that, I got the answer from him. So he has all the power of Krishna is invested in Vrindavan, which is non-different from him, and all the power of Krishna is invested in Sri Gurudev. So we're very, very fortunate that we can hear from his lotus mouth. In the third canto, Srila Prabhupada writes, purporting the prayers of Lord Shiva, that the living entity, although he's forgotten his relationship with Krishna for many millions of births, simply by hearing from the lotus lips of the pure devotee, which is whose words are mixed with the saffron dust particles from the lotus feet of Krishna, although we forgot our relationship with Krishna for many millions of births, that relationship can be easily revived. Gaur Premanandi, Hari Hari.
I request one of the senior most disciple of Swamiji, Sri Irukkuram Prabhu. He has served his Gurudev in many ways, and he was so much pleased to inspire him in Krishna consciousness. So I request him to speak something. How he feels.
Gurave Namaha. Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Shamaniti Namani Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharane Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarne Namo Vishnu Padaya Radhikayai Priyatmane Shri Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Iti Namani Shri Krishna Lila Katane Sudaksham Adorya Madhurya Gunaishcha Yuktam Varam Varenyam Purusham Mahantam Narayanastam Shirsha Namami Namo Mahabhadanaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namni Gaura Trishe Namaha He Krishna Karuna Sindho Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vansha Kalpatrubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhyevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shiva Sadigaur Bhaktavrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare We are very fortunate. We cannot estimate our good fortune in being present on this auspicious occasion, to be sitting in the presence of such a exalted Rasik Mahabhagavat Vaishnav, to be having the opportunity, as Srimati Shamarani Didi said, to even be in his presence, that even a few atoms of prema can come from him into us. This good fortune of ours, we cannot estimate. Srila Narayan Maharaj is the most merciful personality who is coming in his old age, inconvenience of his physical body, to travel in this way to the Western world, to execute the order of his Guru Varga. Only out of his causeless mercy he is coming here. There is no other reason. His desire to give kindness, kripa, karuna, and mercy to all of the fallen jivas, such as ourselves. We also know that our beloved Srila Prabhupada, Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, embarked like this in his old age to the Western world. But his mission was somewhat different in one sense. He had to clear the forests before any seeds could be planted. So much dense forest. What was that dense forest? Nirvishesha Shunyavadi. So much voidism and impersonalism. And he had to somehow or other give a touch of Krishna bhakti to the mlechas and yavanas of the world, completely removed from even human life, living like animals. He had to elevate. So all of his time, Srila Gurudev has expressed this many times to us, that his short period of time in the Western countries was largely taken up executing this task. Because bhakti, in its highest sense, is not something that can be distributed freely to everyone. There has to be some adhikar. And this adhikar is coming from a combination of past sukritis, some kind of samskar. But since we had no actual samskar, we had to be given this. And this was bestowed upon us by the mercy of Srila Prabhupada, in the line of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, Bhaktivinod Thakur, and our Siksh Goswamis, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Baladev Vidyabhushan, all of our great, great Vaishnavacharyas. All of this was bestowed upon us by Srila Prabhupada. But our qualification for taking this and understanding this, what it was that Prabhupada ultimately was giving to us, was limited. We had only gone so far. We could only take so much. So his time was spent in this way, and then he disappeared from this world, leaving behind him a very great legacy. Once Prabhupada was also asked, just before he disappeared, who will replace you after you disappear? Who will be the next acharya? And Prabhupada's simple answer was, all of them, whoever will take the legacy, they can be. But that also implies there has to be some qualification. So in Prabhupada's leaving this world, he also saw the necessity to request that further help be given by personalities who were qualified to give this help to us. And he requested so heartfully to our beloved Srila Narayan Maharaj to kindly help his disciples to go forward in bhakti, to go higher in bhakti. And we cannot even begin to estimate what a great kindness and mercy this was of Prabhupada to ask him to do this. Because at that point, we had a vague idea what is Krishna consciousness. Even some years had been spent doing bhajan sadhana, etc., but still some kind of vague idea. Krishna is the goal, but really what is the goal? What is the ultimate goal? Why we have come to this movement? That took further explanation, further elucidation. So, Vaishnav Sangha, much Vaishnav Sangha was required. And Prabhupada, seeing the necessity of this, requested such an exalted Mahabhagwat to perform this task. And Srila Narayan Maharaj has told us that he took this order from Srila Prabhupada as his considering him to be his worshipable Siksha Guru, that he took this order on his head. Yes, I will do this. And he has vowed that he will do this to his last breath. So how can we estimate how fortunate we are that we have come under his protection, and that now he is coming, even undergoing so much difficulty, to continue giving this to everyone. Anyone who wants to take. He has opened up his warehouse. Srila Narayan Maharaj is an unlimited warehouse of transcendental nectar and ecstasy. He has tasted these highest bhavs of Krishna consciousness. And he is only inviting us continually, come, 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 come. Come on, come on. He's always saying to us. So he is trying to prepare us, asking us, come to Vrindavan. Come on Kartik Parikrama. Yes, yes, you need more Sukriti, more Sukriti, more Sukriti. He's continually telling us, go forward, go forward. Don't mind all of your anartas, all of your so-called disqualifications, never mind. Even tricking us he's doing, somehow or other begging us, come and take this mercy of Srimati Radhika, this mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So, we are only praying that somehow we can render some seva to his lotus feet. As long as he is with us, guiding us, that we can somehow or other continue in his divine service. Srila Gurudev ki jai.
Jnana-timirandhasya jnananjana-salakaya chakshurunvilitam jena tasmai shi gurave nama namong vishnu padaya acharya singha rupini shishyamad bhakti prajnan keshavaiti namine Ati martar charitraya swasitanan chapaline jiva sadataya nam prema pradayine bancha kalpatarubhyasya kripa sindhubhyaiva cha patitanam pamanebhyo vaishnavibhyo namo mahavadannaya krishna prema pradayati Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gauratishai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sivasadi Sri Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama My English is so poor. I cannot express my fully idea in English, but I will try. If it will be needed, it will be translated in English by anyone of you. I'm so happy to come here in Malaysia. In our Brajmandal Parikrama last year, so many devotees went in Brajmandal Parikrama and they requested me to come here. Especially, perhaps you know or not know, I met first to Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, as you call Prabhupada, in 1947, more than 50 years before. He came to Mathura in his last days and took sannyas from our Gurudev. Srila Bhakti Siddh Pragyan Kesava Goswami Maharaj in Mathura. At that time I was there. I helped Swamiji to take sannyas. I made sacrifice, fire sacrifice. Also, I gave danda and his cloth sannyasi. And I taught him how to take it. We were both for so many months in one place in Mathura and Vrindavan in and at Delhi. When he came to Western countries, especially in New York City, 22nd Avenue.
22nd
Avenue. He requested me to send so many mridangs, kartal, his all books. So I sent him all the books with a very great care. So many mridangs, kartals, also Radha Krishna duties, and also a very sweet and very delicious, tasteful sweet of Mathura that is called peda. He was very fond of sweet things. And he wrote me more than 150 letters how he is preaching. And he requested me to come to Western country to help him. But I replied him that I am serving my Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Pragyan Kesava Goswami Maharaj. When need or any appropriate time will come, I will serve you and help you in your Krishna consciousness, preaching over the whole world. I did so. At last, you know, or you don't know, then when he was prepared to go to his Radha Krishna conjugal in his last days, last night, he called me. I went there. And he began to weep, having my hands in his hands. He told that I have brought so many new devotees. He also told that I should not say like that. That he told that I have brought so many devotees like monkeys in their first days. You will have to give something to them and help always. I told him frankly that I will help. I will try to serve and to fulfill your orders. He also told me that my lost anusthan,
ceremony,
lost ceremony, is to give samadhi to him. You know samadhi?
Yeah.
Samadhi. With your own hands, with Vedic culture. There are many his god brothers, like Ban Maharaj and all others were there. His all disciples were there, like Tamal Krishna Maharaj, senior most, Bhavananda, Brahmananda, Jayapataka, Krishnananda, Kirtananda, and all others were there. But I don't know why he get this service, most prominent service to me, because he has some faith on me more than anyone. Because his name was Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj and my name also Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Maharaj in a line. We both took sannyas from same Guru. I honor so much to Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Maharaj, like my Guru of Guru, Param Guru. We are same in line. Our objects were same. Yeah. So he had some faith on me, and that is why he told me to help by all these things. I became so happy and told Pratigya ki,
promise.
I promise that I will try to serve in all respect you have ordered. You are my Shiksha Guru. He wanted to make me sit on his own cot, bed, but I touched the bed on my head and sat down on chair very near to him. And he told me so many things that I don't want to tell you. So many things. Because we are bosom friends, he was also my guru. He was my Shiksha Guru also. So we have so many relations between us. After he is going to Kanjugal in Golok Vrindavan, I wanted to serve him and to help all his disciples. I did so. Even in court, in some case, in Bombay High Court, I will have to go there for evidence. I went there several times with so many problems, but yet I don't care for all these things. I went to serve him. All old devotees know this fact. So I helped him in his lifetime also and after his lifetime. I wanted to, I knew that in a very little time he has spread the mission of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in whole world, in so many countries, about 30 or more than that countries. Also in Muslim countries, what to tell in Christian countries. Christian is like Indian Sanatan Dharma. They believe in God. So much belief. So they are very nearer to us, Sanatan Dharma. Even in Muslim countries he went in his old ways. And in very little time, he established Krishna consciousness. He wrote so many books, authorized books, like Srimad Bhagavatam explanation, Chaitanya Charitamrita explanation. First he did the explanation of Gita as it is, and it went in whole world in a very no time. He has been sent by, so I used to tell that, I think that he has been sent by his divine jugal Krishna and Radhika or Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He was not a very sadharan vyakti,
ordinary person.
He was very powerful acharya, and that is why he spread his mission, not his own mission, but the mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, mission of Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, and all acharyas. I know that he had not done anything new, but the same wine in
new bottle
he has done. At first Rupa Goswami has started, or Jiva Goswami has started. Krishna consciousness is the name of Vishwa Vaishnava Raj Sabha. The meaning is the same as ISKCON means International Society for Krishna Consciousness. So the meaning is the same as Vishnu, Vaishnava, Raj, Sabha. So I think that he was one of the prominent leaders in our disciplic succession. And he gave only the things that Rupa Goswami, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and his most priya bhakta,
intimate association,
like Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, Raghunath Goswami, and all others. He had not given anything new. He has given the same idea, same thing for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to this world to preach and to give. So I know that he had the same mission, same object of preaching. But as my previous bhakta,
speaker,
Sri Urukam Prabhu told me all things, what I
want to say.
For what things I have come, he has expressed very fully. So, only to give the love and affection for conjugal. This was the mission of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. To test something, how test Srimati Radhika, Krishna roop and qualities, and to preach, to give, bestow the modes of the Brajbasi, especially of most dear of Krishna, the gopis, how they loved, how they served Krishna, to sprinkle this thing. What is Krishna praying? So in Chaitanya Charitamrita or the books of Rupa Goswami and Jiva Goswami, we want to achieve our mission and object is to receive Krishna Prem. What is the Krishna Prem? How Brajabasi, his friends, his father and mother, Nanda Yashoda, and especially gopis, used to love Krishna. If you are not in the guidance of gopis and Brajavasi, we cannot achieve that kind of Krishna prem. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to give this because he is so merciful and he is powerful. And also, two qualities, Krishna. Param Karun, Krishna,
Rasik Shekhar.
He is Rasik Shekhar, Krishna. Means, he is enjoyer of all kinds of rasas. And secondly, he is so merciful. Bina hetu. Causeless merciful. That is why Krishna took the shape and mood of Srimati Radhika and came to this world to give this thing to jivas, souls. So he did it. Even what to tell of men and women. Even in forest, he gave this prem to very notorious tigers, lions, elephants, snakes, even to dogs, even to all. It was so strange in the life of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And he ordered all those who are followers that you should tell Krishna to others to whom you are seeing, and tell him to preach Krishna everywhere. So in his lifetime he spread all over India, but not whole world. But his followers, from Rupa Goswami to up to Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj and our Gurudev Srila Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Maharaj, they tried to spread it all over whole world. So my mission is the same as the mission of Swamiji, to give this. Why he could not give it? The reason he spoke to you, that has a very little time. His most of time was gone in clearing the jungles of Mayavad and materialism. So he told me, and I wanted to fulfill his orders. That is why I wanted first that I should treat the places where he went in other countries, where he went and established Krishna consciousness first in America, New York or New Jersey?
New York City.
It is a very great sacred place for me, it was. And from there, I went several places in England and America, even in Canada, so many places, and touched the lotus feet dust of Swamiji there. And I was so much inspired that his all things should be given to whole world. I saw also, and I feel in my heart, that the senior most devotees are somewhat are neglected. They have been separated. They are bound to go out of his home. Some mission of new persons has been derailed. So I wanted to make Krishna consciousness, this ISKCON, so solid that they should be not derailed. So I wanted to meet them and to inspire a new way that they should come in ISKCON and they should preach everywhere where they have not still preached. But they could not understand my this view, and they became opposite. Still, I was always helping them. So now I think that though are in different opinion, and they say that Narayan Maharaj is preaching some difference from Swamiji, but this is not true. But I think that they are preaching and speaking be derailed from the line of Swamiji. Everywhere in Shastra it has been written, they try to honor Shuddha Vaishnav, pure Vaishnav. They think that I am not pure Vaishnav. If they think then they should do, I agree with them. But if they know that I have served him in so many ways that they have not served, when ISKCON was not taken birth, before that I'm serving him. And still in the last days I served him, I was not pure Vaishnava. At that time they were telling that, oh, he is one of the most special Vaishnava in the line of Swamiji. So if anyone is not honoring Vaishnavas, I think that he should honor them. Otherwise bhakti will go away from there. It is not part of pure Vaishnava. If a guru is not honoring any Vaishnava, any acharya, then he is not a pure Vaishnava. That guru should be given up. It has told in epics everywhere. So you should not do like this. Honor all the Vaishnava who are in the line of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu line, or in the line of Rupa Goswami, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur. Don't differentiate between the disciples of Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, and the disciples of Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. They should be in one line. So I was requesting everywhere that don't be derailed. Don't go against bhakti. Even he is not a Kanishta Vaishnava, he is not giving proper respect to proper Vaishnavas, like Kanishta Vaishnava, Madhyam Vaishnava, and Uttam Vaishnava. We should honor them regarding their
position.
Qualifications. So we should do this. So I did it in my tour in Western countries, and I saw that even the disciples of Srila Gaur Govinda Maharaj and others who are preaching the same mission of Swamiji, they are overlooked and neglected. So I should help them. This is my first duty in the line of Swamiji. So even I am ill, my health is not properly advising me, or there are so many reasons, yet I decided to come to Malaysia, to Australia, Singapore, and all other countries. If anyone again invite me, and if my health permits, I try to go there and to help them as I can do. So my purpose is to give pure Krishna Bhakti in the line of Rupa Goswami, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Rupa Goswami, my Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Pragyan, Kesava Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Maharaj, and Reverend Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, in the same line. Also to improve their this bhakti, because it may take several births. We cannot achieve that prema bhakti in the highest topic in one birth. It may take that in one birth we will not be pure Vaishnava. But yet we will have to try that we should know what was the mission of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. What is pure bhakti? How to achieve it? Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur has propagated this mission very well. In very, very simple words, in Bengali or even in English also. He was the seventh Goswami after Rup, Sanatan Bhatta Raghunath, Sijiv Gopal Bhatta Das Raghunath Goswami. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur has given in his Jaiva Dharma, a book name is Jaiva Dharma. He has written so many books. How to achieve bhakti? In Gita explanation or Srimad Bhagavatam or Chaitanya Charitamrita explanations, Swami has given so many things. As it has been given by Rupa Goswami, Sanatan Goswami, Srila Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, or all acharyas. He has given everything, completely he has given in his books. But I think that he has not given everything in his books. Because if he was now alive, he would have written so many books more. Krishna bhakti and Krishna service is so broad, unlimited. Krishna himself cannot explain his all moods. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, he could not give all these things. Rupa Goswami has given. But why Jiva Goswami has written so many books? If Jiva Goswami has given everything in his books, why Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami and Chakravarti Thakur, Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Baldev Vidyasagar, why they have wrote? And if they have written everything, why Swamiji wrote so many books? And if Swamiji has written everything, why the coming Vaishnava will write so many things? It is endless thing. It is always Purna. Purnam adha, Purnam idam, Purnat Purnam uduchyate, Purnasya Purnam eva avashishyate. That is. Limited, unlimited. Anything you can take from endless, unlimited thing, the remaining will be unlimited. So, what is Krishna? He is unlimited. What we take from Krishna, it is unlimited. What remains? So what Swami has written is unlimited. But if anything is written again, this is also unlimited. So we are not going to make him less. But unfortunately, some of ISKCON leaders are not understanding these views. They declare that we should not read any books. Those have been written not by Swamiji. Swamiji has given reference of all these books, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu and all others, Ujjwala Nilmani. But they don't recognize this. This is they are unfortunate. So I'm speaking more than 1 hour.
40 minutes.
Doctor has told me to be careful not to speak so much. I wanted to speak so much things. I wanting to glorify Swami, Swamiji, Bhaktivedanta Swami Narayan. In so many ways. I wanted to glorify Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. I wanted to glorify his all followers. But I am limited person. My everything is limited. So I cannot touch unlimited things. So today, I am requesting you all that you should try to develop your Krishna consciousness. Try to honor all Vaishnavas. Try to honor so much Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj and his pure disciples also, like Gaur Govinda Maharaj. He was just in line of Swamiji. ISKCON leaders, perhaps, they could not appreciate them. They could not understand him, who was he. But I know he was in his line. So, by and by, I am here for 7 days. As the committee or Vaishnavas will allow me to do the service of Swamiji and all Vaishnavas, I will try to serve you all by my words and mood. So today I'm stopping my speech here, having so much honor in the lotus feet of my Reverend Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Pragyan Kishore Maharaj, Swamiji Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, and Guru of both, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada. Gaur Pramanande. Can you tell something? Budhara Prabhu. He is the senior most Vaishnava, one of the senior most Vaishnavas, and he is helping in my previous tour, and also he has so many business, big business, but he left all to help me. So I am requesting him to speak something.
Gyananjana Salakaya Chakshurun Militam Jena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namaham Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pastaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pacharane Nirvisesa Sinyavari Paskata Desatarine Namaham Vishnu Padaya Radhikaya Priyatmane Srimate Bhaktivedanta Narayaniti Namine But I can say maybe just a few things about my feelings about Maharaj and his tour to Western and Eastern countries outside of India. For many years since Srila Prabhupada, Swami Prabhupada's departure, I have associated with and worked with many devotees from ISKCON and outside of ISKCON, followers of other great devotees in our line. And it has been my experience after working as a, I don't know what you want to call it, an astrologer, coach, counselor, whatever the word is, in trying to work with maybe at least 800 devotees over those years. It has become my educated opinion that the devotees in general were hankering for an elevated sadhu sangha, an association with saintly persons who could inspire them in their Krishna consciousness and in their mission to serve the mission of ISKCON and the mission of the Parampara. There have been many, I guess the polite way to say it is unfortunate experiences which have hurt the devotees, caused a lot of pain to them in their aspirations to serve the mission of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And I have often felt that it was so sad that some inspiration was not available in personal form. Sometimes I would meditate on the story of Advaitacharya who would, looking around him, see the sorry state of affairs in Bengal at the time, and many of the devotees of the time would go to him and say, Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, yada yada hi dharmasya glanya bhavati bharata. So, abhyutanam dharmasya tadatmanam shudamyaham. The devotees would ask Advaita Acharya, if Krishna actually is true to his word, then why is it that he has not appeared at a time where things have degraded to such a low condition, where the devotees are suffering, the devotees are at a loss, they don't know to whom to turn or what to do. And under their petition, and also from his own heartfelt feelings, Sri Advaita Acharya worshipped Shalagram on the bank of Gangama and petitioned the Lord with very thunderous cries, very pleading cries to appear. So sometimes I would meditate on that pastime and wonder if at all in my lifetime I would again experience the kind of spiritual inspiration that I experienced with Swami Prabhupada. I have seen the devotees suffer to such an extent that, practically speaking, it is actually indescribable. If you sit and talk with one devotee after another, hundreds and hundreds of devotees, hours and hours and hours, I can only describe a great deal of pain and suffering, all in the name of spiritual experience. And all of these devotees are very high souls, very empowered souls in many ways, and very pure souls. And Kali and his Kali Chelas have done their very best to keep them down, to disempower them, and to administer poison in the presentation of spiritual nectar. So there's been such a need for a great acharya, a great devotee, to come and give the thing, the medicine that would relieve that pain and relieve that suffering. Individually, we can only do so much. I have personally tried, and I have tried a little bit, one by one. But it takes a great devotee to come and to be able to inspire the masses of devotees to once again take up in a very happy, enthusiastic way the mission of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in a unified way, to once again take up the mission of Swami Prabhupada and the other great devotees in the parampara. So I guess I'm a little bit speaking longer than I thought, a little bit long-winded. But the point I want to make is that...
It's not long-winded.
No, okay. Okay. The point I want to make is that our hearts are hankering, both devotees and non-devotees. We're hankering for something sublime. We're hankering for the joy that we know comes from Krishna, comes from Sri Chaitanya. And I personally have witnessed many, many cases where His Divine Grace Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayan Maharaj has inspired the devotees to take up spiritual life with renewed vigor. He has underscored for them their important position as servants of the parampara in the far-flung corners of the globe. And I think that Maharaj has undertaken this mission. Actually, I can tell you, I know for a fact, I have personal experience in many different ways, that this is being undertaken at the request of Srila Prabhupada, Srila Swami Prabhupada, as we call him. He has undertaken this at great personal hardship. It's been an adventure for all of us to see day by day how in the face of personal discomfort and personal risk that Maharaj has come to us and has undertaken this travel. And I believe that together, hand in hand, he is serving Bhaktivedanta Swami just so that he can relieve that pain and inspire us all and uplift us all so that again together we can really serve that mission. So it's a great historic event, I believe, and one that will go down in the annals of Vaishnava history, that at such an advanced age, also like Swami Prabhupada, he has come at this great risk to touch all of our hearts, your hearts, my hearts. I know he's touched my heart. I had given up hope that there would ever be such a person again like his caliber amongst us. And I can say that he's opened up many new avenues of spiritual life, I know for me and for many of my God brothers and God sisters. So I feel that it's a great opportunity. I personally have encouraged many devotees to, like I have, put things aside and take the risks to associate, take the risks of, let's say, neglecting personal affairs to associate with Maharaj, and to put our might and our will and our energies behind this opportunity to say to our God brothers and God sisters and those who are their disciples that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and the Parampara actually does love us, they care for us, and they want us to be inspired in our service. And to me, Maharaj is that inspiration. And I'm putting my weight and myself in my humble way behind this mission so that the devotees can have some of that experience. Thank you very much.
Also, you have the same mood for preaching the mission of Swamiji. Now, you should do Kirtan, Mahamantra. Both lines at it. Do tie eggs on it. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Rama.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Shashikala, what sort of hair that he
wanted to give out in the West? So this is Shashikala sent it from Vrindavan.
Radhe Radhe Govinda Govinda Radhe. Astu Tarasata Shishi Mathis Vangra Shil Goga Vinaswamaraj, Kapudanta Swamaraj, Shil Prabhupada. Jai Nitinura Pavishtam Vishnupad Paramaham Supriraj, Akchari Astu Tarasata Shishi Mathis Vangra Shil Bhakti Praganke Shil Goswamaraj. Jai Nitilila Pavishtam Vishnupad Paramaham Supriraj, Akchari Astu Tarasata Shishi Mathis Vangra Shil Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswamaraj, Shil Prabhupada. Jani to Lila Pavishtam Vishnupad Paramahamsa Privaj, Gacharyas to Shishimad, His Divine Grace, Shil Goroki Shodas Babaji Maharaj. Jani to Lila Pavishtam Vishnupad Paramahamsa Privaj, Gacharyas to Shishimad, His Divine Grace, Shil Satyananda Bhakti Nal Thakur. Ananta. Jani to Lila Pavishtam Vishnupad Paramahamsa Privaj, Shila Bhakti Rakshad, Shrita Dev, Shrita Maharaj King, Namachar Shila Haridas Thakur King, Prem Sakal Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Veta Gadadha Shri Sadi Gaur Bhakti Niki, Shri Shri Radha Krishna Gop Gopna Sham Kun Radha Kun Giri Govdhan King, Shri Vrindavan Dham King, Shri Navdeep Mayapur Dham King, Shri Jagannapuri Dham King, Yamuna Maya King, Ganga Maya King, Tulsi Devi King, Bhakti Devi King, Hari Nam Sankirtan King, Shri La Prabhupada's Transcendental Book Distribution King, Brihatma Danga King, Gaur Premananda, Gaur Glorious Son Devotees.